So this is Dottie. I've built Dottie over 19 years, and when I first take off in Dottie, it will be the first flight, so I am the test pilot. You might ask yourself, how do I know I'm not going to kill myself? Great question. The most critical part of an airplane is the wing, specifically the shape of the airfoil. Now, I just didn't draw a pretty little airfoil on a piece of paper and use that. There are textbooks with hundreds of airfoils, and each one has thousands of hours of wind tunnel testing to determine its characteristics and its safe operating range, specifically where the center of gravity needs to be. In this video, we're going to do the very critical center of gravity measurements. So everyone knows it. So I have 800 pounds of kettlebells, literally. If I put them in the cockpit with me, I'd be fine. The plane would fly correctly. But most everyone would guess that if I put 800 pounds of kettlebells in the nose, what's gonna happen? Right, the plane's gonna crash. The nose will never be able to get up. It'll just go down the runway dragging its nose. Similarly, what would happen if I put 800 pounds of kettlebells on the tail? Right, the tail would go down, the nose would go up, and the plane would crash. The weight has to be in a very specific place, and that's what all the wind tunnel testing determines. I know that on this airplane, see these pieces of tape here? If the center of gravity is between these two pieces of tape, it'll fly great. If it's not, I crash. So you make sure the center of gravity is between those two pieces of tape. That's what we're gonna do. So we're gonna measure the weight on each wheel when it's in this flying position it is now. And then we're gonna measure where those are compared to the datum, which is the leading edge. That's where the textbooks refer to. It's really pretty simple. Let's go ahead and do it. The first part of doing the weight and balance is making sure that the aircraft is perfectly level in two directions. So you can see we're level here, and also I've got a level between the two door frames, and you can see I'm level in this direction. You'll notice here's the ramp I use to get the wheels up on a block so that I can roll onto the scale without affecting the leveling at all. In this level position, the tail wheel is 35¾ inches above the hangar floor to the axle of the tail wheel. So it's important to note that this aircraft has everything on it that it will on the first flight. This is its true empty weight. It's got the upgraded tail wheel, all the covers are on, the inspection holes, the turtle deck is on, the wingtips are on, I've got my upgraded Tundra tires, the spinner and prop are on, all the cowling is on, everything is ready to go. The fuel has been drained, the interior is completely installed, including fire extinguisher, all the instruments, so we've got a true empty weight here. So we're measuring the weight on the right main. The aircraft is still level in both planes. You'll notice here, the wheel is squarely on the scale. It's not touching the front, so it's not leaning on it. There's nothing else on the aircraft. Everything is free. The doors are closed as it would be in flight. So let's look at the weight. We have 340 plus 47.4, so that's 387.4. Okay, we're measuring the weight on the left main here. Notice the tail is on the sawhorses, It's still completely level in two directions. The tire is squarely on the weight pad. There's a gap between the front of the tire and the scale, so it's not resting on that. And our weight is, notice, 340 on the bottom, 38 on the top. So we're looking at 378 on the left main. Okay, now we're gonna measure the weight on the tail wheel. You'll notice I have it on the middle of the scale here. The aircraft is still level in two directions. You'll notice the mains are up on their platforms as they have been the whole time, at scale height above the ground. And what we have here, 50 on the main and 0.5 pounds. So we have 50.5 pounds resting on the tail wheel. So now we have the weight put on each wheel. What do we do with that? Again, the big picture of what we're trying to do is keep the airplane from crashing. Each airfoil has a very specific center of gravity range where the wing will perform well and safely. Outside of that range, you crash. See those two pieces of tape up there? As long as the aircraft balances between those two, I'm fine. So that's what I'm doing here. I need to find out where the center of gravity is. So in other words, if I could lift the plane up with one finger, where could I balance it? For the center of gravity calculations, everything is in relation to the leading edge. So the first thing I'm gonna do is use my plumb line again to drop a line down to make the datum line, which is the leading edge. All the weights are gonna be measured from that. So then all we have to do is see how far in front or behind of the datum the left wheel is, the right wheel is, and the tail wheel is. Now let's actually do that. All we have to do is drop a plumb line from the axle and compare it to the datum. First thing, we need to confirm that the aircraft is still level in two planes because all the plumb bob measurements need to be made exactly in the same orientation as we weighed each wheel. So then we're gonna drop a plumb line from the tailwheel axle down to the floor and mark a cross under the plumb bob. Next, we do the same thing and drop a plumb bob line from the leading edge on both sides and the axle of the main wheels on each side. Now let's look at the line because that's important. Let's first look at the leading edge. So this right here, this mark, is the leading edge. This mark right here is the axle. And you'll notice the axle is 1/16 behind this datum line right there. So it's nearly on it, but it's a little aft of the datum line. Now let's look at the right tire. This is a line dropped from the leading edge. So this is the datum line. This right here is right below the axle. So you'll notice again, the axle is 1/16 of an inch behind the datum line, nearly on it. Now let's look at the tail wheel. So a measure from under the tail wheel, the cross I made there, and measure that to the datum line directly in the middle. And we see that is 163.5 inches. So now we have the weights acting at three different points. Now I can calculate the weight and balance with a spreadsheet. So let me show you what you do with those numbers. So here's the stats on my aircraft. And here's the information that we measured. So the weight on the left main, the weight on the right main, the weight on the tail wheel, this 1/16 inch that we measured, and this 163 inches we measured to the tail wheel.
Multiply those out and we get a total moment of 8304. Divide that by the weight of 815 pounds, which is the empty weight, and we get an empty center of gravity at 10.2 inches. So let's take this example, 220 pound pilot, me, with 180 pound passenger, that's Scott plus Milo, half fuel and baggage. So the empty weight of the aircraft is 815.9 pounds. The empty arm is 10.178. So there's the moment you'll recognize that number. The pilot, me, 220 pounds at 18 inches behind the leading edge, makes this moment. The passenger, 180 pounds, again, 18.3 inches behind the leading edge, makes this moment. The fuel, which is half a tank, 13 gallons, is 16.5 inches behind the leading edge, making this moment. The cargo, 26 pounds, at 46.9 inches behind the leading edge, makes this. So here is the total moment. Divided by the weight makes this center of gravity. And you'll notice that is in the safe range, which is between 11 3/8 and 16 inches. So this is what pilots do each time before a flight, is go to this spreadsheet and make sure that that all-important center of gravity is where it needs to be. That's how you fly safe instead of crashing.